Hello everybody and welcome back to Cooking with Grandma. Today we're going to be making a casserole. This is kind of one of those change it up casseroles. You can sort of add different ingredients if you like. It is a pizza casserole and I got it from allrecipe.com. It's a good website to go to find pretty much anything you want. So right now what I'm doing is I'm browning some ground beef. And just turn down my heat because that's going to get going too quickly. I'm going to brown some ground beef. Now, the change up here, it calls for ground beef, but I guess you could use ground chicken or ground pork. Although, it'll change your taste if you do change your protein meat. So, I have the beef, I'm going to use it. It calls for a green bell pepper. I have yellow and red, so I'm using yellow. That doesn't matter. It's not going to change the taste. It's just going to be a different color. Instead of green, it'll be yellow and obviously or red, whatever you have on hand. That's what is nice about these kind of recipes. You don't have to go to extremes. You can just buy, or you know, if you have what you have in your cupboard, in your fridge, in your pantry. So I'm going to get this going, and then to this we're going to add one onion that's chopped, and I did this beforehand just to make it a little quicker. We're going to throw that in, and one yellow pepper, in this case green pepper, but it calls for it. When I put the recipe in the description box, I will put it as written, but you guys feel free to change it up like I am. If you don't have a green pepper, you know, use red, yellow. If you don't like green peppers, just leave it out. So I'm going to find my garlic powder here. There you go. And I'm going to put, it calls for 2 cloves of garlic minced. I have garlic powder, so I'm going to put 2 teaspoons of garlic powder instead of using whole garlic. You can do that. You can either way. I mean, when you're substituting spices, that doesn't really matter. That is not going to hurt. It's still going to have that little bit of a garlicky flavor. So we're going to mix all that good. So we are browning the ground beef with the onion, the garlic, the pepper. And then we have to drain off the excess fat, which doesn't look like there's going to be very much. This is a very lean burger. And over here in this pot, I'm cooking the noodles. It calls for egg noodles. I'm using spaghetti that I just broke up small. Egg noodles around my area, if you can find them at all, they come in very small bags. So I would need like 2 or 3 to feed my family. And they're a lot more expensive than just, you know, your basic. Noodles are noodles, pasta is pasta. I mean, some people will argue with me about that one, but if you sat down and blindfolded yourself and took a taste of elbow macaroni, and then a taste of spaghetti, and then a taste of like the curly noodles, or the tube noodles, except for the shape, you're not gonna be able to tell which is which. The taste is gonna be the same. Oh, okay, so I know if you leave me in the comments and disagree with me, that's okay. There are some people out there that swear by they only can eat elbow macaroni because they don't like spaghetti. It's pretty much all the same. So I'm going to use I'm going to use spaghetti noodles that I've cut up. I broke in threes instead of leaving it whole, and that kind of mimics the size of the egg noodle. They're almost done. I'm going to drain these while I'm finishing the burger. We need 2 cups of uncooked, but then obviously it makes a lot more. It's almost double that when it's cooked. So I've got my ground beef, my onion, and my pepper browning nicely. I'm just going to give it a little bit more. There's still a chunk. It is going to go into the oven, so if it's not all the way done through, it'll finish cooking in the oven. But I'm going to go ahead and make sure it's all the way cooked. And before I do put it in my casserole dish. This is a really easy, quite versatile dish. It's, like I said, a switcho chingo. It calls for pepperoni sausage. I'm out of pepperoni. You can use ham, you can use bacon. I'm gonna really be cheapy today, and I cut up hot dogs. I cut up small hot dogs that are the little slices that look like pepperoni slices. So that's going to go in there. When you get all the sauce in there, not going to matter. The taste isn't going to be... I'm not a pepperoni fan. if I get pizza, I don't get it with pepperoni. So, you know what, we're just gonna go with what you got, because I really didn't want to go to the store, but I really wanted to make this recipe for all y'all today. Okay, so now that's all done, cooked. Drain the excess fat. Well, there really isn't any, if you can see me tipping the pan, there really isn't any fat to drain. So I'm just gonna go ahead and leave that on. And I'm gonna add my other ingredients to the pan. I had everything out on my counter except the milk. I totally forgot to get the milk out. So now what we do is we stir in the noodles right in this big pan. We stir in the noodles, the pepperoni, the pizza sauce, and the milk. So I'm gonna turn the heat off, and I'm just gonna go ahead and stir everything in. I'm gonna move this over just a little so we can see it better. There we go. And you can see how it actually looks kind of nice with the yellow in there rather than the green. It gives it a more bigger pop of color. So we're going to stir in our noodles. There we go. And we're going to stir in our baked pepperoni. Again, if you like pepperoni, go ahead and put it in. If you don't like it, you can eliminate it. You can add ham, you can add bacon. I did make this one time before and I used bacon and it was really good. If you like bacon on your pizza, same idea. So we're gonna put the pepperoni on the pizza sauce. Again, spaghetti sauce works just as well. It's 2 cups, 16 ounces. The pizza sauce, like, we get it here in the stores and it's small cans for like 6 ounces, I think. So therefore I would need like 4 cans. Just buy spaghetti sauce. It's basically the same. And now we have to add 4 tablespoons of milk. I don't know, I'm not sure why the milk goes in there, but it's in the recipe, so I'm doing it. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And we're going to give that a good mix. And then we're going to put this into a casserole dish and bake it for like 20 minutes, I believe the recipe says. And then we top it with 1 cup of cheddar or mozzarella cheese and put it back in the oven for another 5 minutes, basically till the cheese is melted. It won't take very long at all. So, and that is it. I mean, simple, right? Easy peasy ingredients, easy peasy to do. Cook your noodles, brown your ground beef, add an onion, a pepper, pepperoni, bacon or ham, garlic powder, or if you want to use whole garlic, go for it. Mine's all the way out in the garage hanging up to keep it fresh, and I just really didn't want to go out there and get it, so I'm just using garlic powder. It works too. I can still smell the garlic, so that's good. You don't want a heavy garlic taste, especially if you're serving this to kids. So that, it's all mixed up. That's how quick and easy that was. And now I'm going to put it into a 2-cup casserole dish. This, pour it right in there, very carefully, because I'm doing this on top of my stove and I don't want it to go all down my burner. So it was probably not a good idea. I should have done it on the counter. So I'm just gonna hope I'm gonna get lucky here and not slop too much. There we go. Perfect. Get it all in there. Now this will probably feed, like, depending on the serving sizes, it should feed about 6-7 people. Depending on how big your appetites are and how much people want, but it's gonna serve. So there we go. It is quite a lot. I probably cooked a little bit too much of the spaghetti. It's always more when it's cooked. So anyway, it's okay. It fills it up really nicely. So I'm going to put this in the oven for 20 minutes and I'll come back and show you what it looks like cooked, and we'll add the cheese and we'll finish it off. All right, so now I've got our pizza casserole out of the oven and this is what it looks like. Looks pretty yummy. And I'm going to top it with cheddar cheese. You can use mozzarella if you like, and you can use cheddar. I did have mozzarella, and I took it out of the fridge, and it was a little not in such good shape. So I'm going to use cheddar. Some people just cut around the mold when things go bad. No, it's just in the garbage. So we're going to top it like this. Then you stick it back in the oven. It says 5 to 10 minutes, basically just long enough for the cheese to melt. You want to get it covered, the whole thing. And it calls for a cup. I mean, if you want to, you can always add a little bit more if you like it extra cheesy or if it doesn't cover the surface. So I'm going to stick that back in the oven for like 5 minutes, probably 2 or 3. The oven's pretty hot. And I'll show you what the finished product looks like in just a couple minutes. Alrighty, and there is our pizza casserole all finished. Look at how yummy that looks. Great and cheesy. I'm going to just scoop out some and put it on a plate to show you the whole effect, what it looks like inside. Now, what I did before I started my video is I prepped everything. I chopped my onion, I chopped my pepper, I had my macaronis cooking, the water boiling, and the noodles in while I was doing other things. So if you do it in steps like that, it's a lot quicker. You just go ahead and get everything prepped. Chop your onion, set it aside. Chop your pepper and set it aside. Measure out your sauce and your cheese and whatever else, you know, I did the pepper. I had my ground beef ready to ground. So get it all done like that. Ow, don't touch the hot pan that just came out of the oven. And if you get it all ready ahead of time, it takes like 10 minutes prep time and 25 minutes to cook. So there's what it looks like, all on the plate, all pretty good. And you can see how nice and creamy and rich it looks. It's kind of like just spaghetti, but it's got the pizza flavoring. It's got the pepperoni and the cheese and the meat and the spices. So that is what is for dinner tonight. Leave me a comment below and a like. Let me know what you think of it, if you've tried it or if you want to try it. The recipe will be in the description box below. You can use the substitutes I used in mine if you don't have what it actually calls for. I will write it out as it calls for it, and you can decide which way you want to go. So whatever you choose, go for it. And have a super lovely, yummy day. Bye now.